In this video, I just would like to show you how you can embed an MP4 video inside a LaTeX document or a Bemer presentation. It's going to be super simple. So I'm opening the document, the PDF document, using Foxit Reader, and you can see an image here, which is just a placeholder. If I click on the image, Foxit Reader will display this message, and it's asking me if I want to open this MP4 file. I just have to click on yes, and the video will start playing inside the PDF. This is super handy because the video is embedded inside the PDF itself. So if you send the PDF to someone else or you move it to another folder, you will not have any issue. The video is embedded inside it, so you can share the PDF without worrying that the link will break. In this video, I will also show you how to add autoplay. So every time I go to page one, then this message will pop up and I just have to press yes and the video will autoplay. And finally, I will also show you how to add a link to a YouTube video if you want to. So here we have a thumbnail that we can click and then a new page is going to be open automatically, as you can see here, and I have the video that now is playing on YouTube.
Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how you can add
this functionality, not the link to YouTube but the embedding of the video, does not work in Sumatra PDF. Also, it does not work in Adobe Acrobat Reader. So just keep in mind that I haven't tested all the PDF viewer out there, but it's working on Foxit Reader. So in this video, I'm going to show you all the source code that you need to write to embed this video, and you will see that it's super simple. As usual, I will put all the source code that I use down in the video description, and if you have any question, any comments, or anything that you would like to share with me, just please write a comment down in the video below. Before starting with the code, I just would like to thank all my subscribers on YouTube. I've recently reached a great milestone, so I recently reached 1,000 subscribers, and I really would like to thank all the people that are supporting me, and this has helped me a lot, and this gives me motivation to release new and more videos. Here I'm using Textify, which is a plugin of PyCharm. Of course, this will work also if you are compiling your document locally with an either IDE. So you can use VS Code if you prefer, you can use TextMaker, but just to let you know that anything will do. I'm using Textify because I really like it. I will put a link here at the top right of the video to my link on how to get started with Textify because I think it's great. Here on the left, I have all my source directory, which is here, src. So inside here, I have a file, a text file, which will contain all the code that we need to write to embed the video and to create this function here, embed video. Then we have the main.txt file, which is the main text file that allows us to generate the main PDF. We have the presentation.txt file, which has the source code for the Bemer presentation. Then we have an image, which I just downloaded from Unsplash, and this is just an image of the sea that I'm using here as the thumbnail for the video. I have the video, which is an MP4 video. Any video will do, which is an MP4. So just keep in mind that it's because you are embedding the video file inside your PDF, then the PDF final size will be a function of the video size. And then we have another thumbnail, which I just wanted to show you how you can change the thumbnail in of the video or the image that is actually going to be showing here on your text. Of course, you can choose any type of image that you want and that you prefer. So let's have a look at the main.txt file. Let me collapse this project view and let's see what we need. So of course, we're writing a LaTeX document. So we are starting with document class article. When we're going to create a presentation, we're going to use document class Bemer, but we'll cover that later. And then we are importing this text file, which is embedvideo.txt. Inside here, there is all the code necessary to create the function to embed the video. I didn't write myself this code, but I got it from a great post here on Text Stack Exchange, and I have to thank Alex G for writing this function and to writing this post, which has been extremely useful for me, so I could reuse this code to write my code and to create this video. So don't worry too much about this code, it's very verbose and very long, but you will not have to, you just have to copy it inside your project. And you can copy it here directly into the preamble, but I like to keep my document not as little verbose as possible, so I'm just using the input embedvideo.txt. Then we need the package graphics, because that's needed in order to add the images. We need the package use package hyperref only if you want to add a link to a YouTube video. You don't have to do that, and YouTube video are not embedded. So they have the benefit of the fact that they are not embedded inside our PDF, so our PDF is going to be much lighter. But at the same time, if someone click on our video, they will not play directly inside the video, but the user will be redirected, as we saw before, to YouTube. So it's up to you to choose whichever way you prefer. And then you are not going to need the Lipsum package. I'm just using it to create some placeholder text, as you can see here on my screen. So let's see what we need to write and what we need to do to embed a video inside our PDF. We just have to create a begin document. Then we have a section, nothing crazy here, with a label. Then we have just some text, and here is the whole code that we need to embed a video. So in order to embed a video, we wrap the embed video command inside a begin center environment, just because I like to have my video nice and centered here. Then we put the asterisk if we want that the video autoplays when a person navigates on this video or on the page where the video is in our document. If we remove the asterisk, the video will not play. Inside the first curly braces here, we just have to put the image. Of course, it is very important that we have this image here in our project. So here we have the c.jpg. No need to specify the extension of the image. And we add the image with the include graphics, square braces, we specify the width of the image. And then here we are defining the name of the image, which in our case is c. And then we specify the location of the video. So the video currently is inside the same directory as the main.txt file. So we just have to say c.mp4. Of course, you can store all your video in a folder called videos. In that case, you will have to import the video from a subdirectory and will be like videos/c.mp4. If you want to have a video that plays on click, as I previously mentioned, you just have to remove the asterisk, and then you just have to use the same command, include graphic with textwidth C, and then cmp4. I can simply press Shift F10 to recompile the document. As you will see here at the bottom, the document is recompiling, and it is generating a new PDF. If I see exit code equal to 0, it means that everything is working. Of course, as I said before, you can, of course, change the image. So if I want to have this thumbnail of my video also here in the first video, I just have to change this thumbnail and then press Shift F10, and this is going to recompile the document. And as you can see here, I have now a different image for the placeholder for the video. Just to show you, and to show you how I'm compiling the document, I'm using the compiler, which is PDF LaTeX, and I'm using all the default, so nothing special on that side or nothing else that you need to configure. And I'm using Windows. I'm using the latest version of TextMaker, PyCharm, and the latest version of the window at the time of recording of this video, which is September 2021. Things may change in the future because I've read that there is some work that has been put in updating some packages for LaTeX to embed videos, but all this is working. Now, let's have a quick look how to do the same thing in a presentation. In PyCharm, I can navigate to the presentation.txt file, and of course, I could have accessed that file also here from the sidebar, so presentation.txt. And here we have a very simple presentation. I just wanted to keep it simple. So we have a document class Bemer. We are importing that embedvideo.txt file because we want to import this embed video function. Then here we have begin document and end document. And inside here we have two frames, one in which I'm going to add a video and the second one in, I just thank the viewers. So let me open the presentation.pdf. As you can see, this is how it's looking right now. Let's change the thumbnail to the image just to show you that everything is working. So right now I'm compiling the wrong document because I'm still compiling main. So let's compile presentation. And here I can just do Ctrl Shift F10 because I'm inside this file. This of course will only apply if you're using TextMaker. And as you can see now, I have changed the image, the placeholder for the video. Of course, I can change everything. I can change the title and so on. Let me show you the last thing. So here I have the presentation. As I previously mentioned, I can just open it with Foxit Reader and I can play the video. This is going to play the video of the C that I was using. Of course, I can also copy this presentation. So let me show you. So I copy this document here. I copy it to the downloads or to the desktop. I can paste it here just to show you. As you can see, it's quite big because it has the video embedded, but moving it to another location, it has not affected the video. So I can still click and then I can still play the video inside here, the presentation. And the same is true for the document created with LaTeX. One small thing that I wanted to show you is that if you right click here and you try to open it with Adobe Acrobat Reader DC, in my case it's not working. So as you can see, if I click here on the video, I have to say option and trust this document always. It is connecting, but you will see that it doesn't play the video. It only plays the sound. But for this particular video here, there is no sound, so it just plays a straight line. If you have a video with sound, it will show the wave equation of the sound, but unfortunately, in my case, it's not working. If you find out how to fix this problem, just maybe write a comment down below. But with Foxit Reader, it's working perfectly fine. So I would just recommend you to use Foxit Reader. I really hope you found this video interesting. If you did, please consider liking my video and subscribing to my channel. If you have any question, please feel free to leave the question in the comment section below. If you want to support this channel, you can buy me a coffee, more information in the video description below, or you can support me on Patreon. I have a new account and I put the link in the video description. Thank you very much for listening and see you in the next video.